Recent ideas emerging within the field of astrobiology have opened up the possibility of detecting not just the gases produced by life in the spectra of exoplanet atmospheres, there can be a lot of false positives there, but actually detecting direct evidence of vegetation covering a planet's surface, reflecting infrared light, and creating a distinctive red edge in the spectrum. While this has not yet been detected with any other planet other than Earth, it provides a way for a future dead ringer for the detection of alien plant life. But it wouldn't say much else other than an exoplanet has plants on it. It would not reveal the presence of a civilization. Because of that, some recent attention has been paid to figuring out how to specifically detect a civilization in a more passive way than a radio signal. That's easier said than done. The problem with detecting alien civilizations, the Kardashev scale and so on, is that we can only speculate about what alien civilizations might do. For example, we assume that they would explore space, but nothing actually says that they would, and only due to modern science and technology do we even understand that we can go to space. For most of human history, this was not so. In the end, we must go on our sampling of one until we actually see what a technological alien civilization actually does. When it comes to artificial things that we do that might be detectable by aliens, it includes things like CFCs in our atmosphere that have no ready natural source, or evidence of our satellite networks or megastructures that we might someday build, or even our city lights on the nighttime side of Earth. But in addition to these things, it might be possible to detect something else, alien photovoltaic arrays for power generation. In a paper by Manasvi Lingham and Abraham Loeb, link below, they detail that silicon-based solar power arrays on an exoplanet should be detectable. On our own world, we use these with increasing regularity, and that may mean that some alien civilizations use them as well. But there's a sticking point here in that only exoplanets with relatively transparent atmospheres close into their stars are likely to be able to use solar panels on a planetary scale. But say they did, the authors note that this would cause a detectable artificial edge distinct from the red edge of plants in the infrared spectrum that could be detected by currently planned telescopes. They also point out that photovoltaic arrays would be particularly useful on planets within the habitable zones of red dwarfs. This is because of tidal locking, which is likely to occur with worlds orbiting closely to red dwarfs. On an inhabited but tidally locked world, a civilization could use these arrays to transfer heat and light from the permanently lit side of the planet to the dark side. You might also see discrepancies in the vegetation red edge that defy normal models, suggesting that heat and light are being artificially used to sustain vegetation on the night side of an exoplanet. Or you might even see other structures that produce this artificial edge, perhaps indicating active terraforming, artificial photosynthesis, or even inexplicable signatures of technologies we have yet to imagine. Thanks for listening. I am science fiction author and futurist John Michael Godier, currently biologically hijacked by cold viruses for reproductive purposes. Or perhaps it's just another nefarious pollen-based weapons attack by the plants. I'm under siege, I tell you, but something fun is on the way. Later this week, I'll be doing another collaboration with astrophysicist Paul Sutter, including a nice hour-long informal science chat. Look for it on Friday, and check out my books at your favorite online book retailer, and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.